She's bold, she's fearless, she wears what she likes and talks her mind. Swara Bhaskar is our guest on Fashion, Fashion and all that today. Hi Swara, welcome to Spot Boy.
Thank you, Aditi.
So let's start with, you know, you were never segmented into the fashionista section initially in your career. Of course, then Veeradi wedding happened and then that people saw your glamorous side and that. But how difficult was it to break through in an industry which is for actresses primarily, you know, you need to look a certain way?
Well, I mean, I think that for me, the most difficult thing was to reconcile my personality and with the requirements of the glamour world, because I'm a like full jhalli, like as a personality, like I didn't come from that, you know, I didn't come from a place where how you looked mattered. My parents always gave us, you know, when we were little children, they taught us the opposite, that it doesn't matter how you look. Beauty is not important. It's your, you know, beauty is inside you and all that, you know, those kind of values, like very like I actually remember when my mom, when I was very little and I used to be like, you know how all young girls go through that vanity wala phase and they'd be preening in front of the mirror. My mother would just be like, stop spending so much time in front of the mirror. Like, stop it, you know, go read a book, do something else. Like, you know, like develop your mind. And so when I came to this industry, I was like absolutely not prepared as a personality for this industry. I often used to feel like my soul is only the wrong soul. Like, mere ko to abhi bhi lagta hai ki my greatest achievement in Bombay is that I've learned to stand straight wearing heels and I can now do makeup and all. So, it was a struggle with myself primarily and to understand. And I think I fought it a lot initially. Like, I'd be like, no, what is the need to dress a certain way or look a certain way? And then my mom said a very right thing to me. She said, do you want to spend all your energy fighting the basic, like, you know, fighting this battle? I mean, if it is a requirement and if those are the rules of the game, just play the game by the rules and reach a place where you can then, where you will have enough influence for people to listen to you, and then you can, you know, turn the light back on and say like, okay, let's talk about this. Let's talk about norms of beauty. Let's talk about body shaming. Let's talk about those things. And that made a lot of sense to me. And then I also realized that, look, it's a very first impressions driven industry. So, I mean, like, really, I mean, is this the battle I want to fight? Like, if, you know, if you have to look a certain way at a red carpet, if you have to look a certain way at a meeting, if the press is going to be there and you're going to get papped, just do it, man. How does it matter? You know, there are greater battles to fight.
To fight.
Correct. Than did Swara Bhaskar wear makeup and come off, did she land up without makeup?
So, it's of course, your talent got you through, you know, of course, you had a very strong backing with your talent. But then, again, I'll put my question again in other words. Did you ever feel that struggle, or, you know, you wanted to just feel that, yaar, chalo, kari lete hain ye glamorous role, because is this the...
No, but even the glamorous roles that I've done have been so content heavy. I mean, Veere, yes, it's glamorous, but it's such a great film.
It was beyond your looks, definitely.
Yeah,
your character was beyond
it. Was a great performance, it was a great part to be in. So I think that I've been lucky, like Anarkali, which is a desi glam kind of a role, Anarkali of Ara. It was the till that point, like, the, I mean, we used to take me 3 hours to do that makeup and get into that costume, that dancer's costume and so on. But that's, I mean, there is not, there, I think in my career, it's the most content heavy film I've done.
Right.
So I think that that's been great for me. Like, I've been able to balance that quite nicely. And of course, Veere was like, I mean, I died. Like, I told Riya, I'm terrified of the clothes. Like, every day I was existing in a state of terror ki aaj kya kapde pehnayenge. So, but it was great. And I mean, I looked amazing and Riya's like just brilliant, so.
Of course. Let's talk about red carpets. Do you find them nerve-wracking, or do you like, are you okay with it? Are you comfortable with it?
No, I've learned now to play that game, and I know what to, I know what the whole red carpet dynamic is. I'm very simple. I don't use my brain. Okay, where I know that there is a requirement to look a certain way, I'm like, I call it the stylist. It's, I'm like, it's your job. It's, yeah, there's a team, there's a hair and makeup team, there's a styling team. And I'm like, do your thing.
And what do you think about the Indian fashion industry? Or anything you think that should change in the functioning or should work in some other way? The modeling industry or the glamour world, anything which you feel?
I think that all our industries need to have a very, very honest discussion about the casting couch and about power dynamics and about exploitation. I think that that's a conversation that began but didn't go very far, and it needs to be picked up again. I think that the fashion industry, I don't know a lot
you
about
think
the
there's
industry.
More in
they
fashion
all seem
industry?
Really talented to me. I don't know. I'm
never
not part of the
first-hand experience
I'm not,
ever.
I'm not part of the fashion industry as such. I mean, I think that any industry that has such high stakes of power, they'll always be people who will want to abuse that power and exploit it.
Right.
I think that, that we need to create a situation where the people who are, who don't have power and the people who are more vulnerable should be able to find some kind of protection and justice.
Let's talk about paparazzi culture now. It's like it's everywhere. You step out down your building, they'll be standing. Does it annoy you sometimes because you're not always dressed to be clicked?
No, I'm never dressed to be clicked unless I have been forewarned. And it's a mess. And I've always been like, I mean, the number of like awful, embarrassing photos of me out there is another level. Like I went once to the chemist at Fever and all, and they've clicked me there. So I exist in terror of the paparazzi. But abhi ye kya kar sakte hain?
But kabhi aapne bola hai paparazzi ko yaar, you know,
main to jab dekhte hain modi chhod do yaar kya kar rahe ho, ki jab halat dekho and like, are nahi ma'am, are nahi ma'am, I have a ridiculous relationship with the paparazzi. I'm always requesting them not to take photos, they're always taking them anyway. So but it's all right, they're doing their job, I guess. I mean, like, there is that curiosity in our lives and in the lives of celebrities.
Let's talk about
hazard.
Fashion critiques now.
Yeah. Let's talk about Aditi.
Yes.
How many times have you put me on the worst dress list?
So I'm sitting right in front of you. Any message you want to give them? Because always you have an opinion on things. So I'm sure you'll have one on this.
No, I have
also.
No opinion.
Anything?
I actually don't have opinions on fashion and on clothes.
But anything you want to tell them?
I mean, no, it's just, I mean, it's all right. Like, I think that, that you all are also doing your job, I suppose, right? Like, I think that, that tastes can differ. It's okay.
Okay. Yeah.
I think that where we should all agree that what is a problem is plagiarism and is people stealing other people's ideas or designs
styles
or outfits without crediting them.
Hmm.
I think that is, to me, if you if you ask me that, is there an opinion, I think that is my opinion.
Okay.
That we should protect the people whose original works are being copied without credit. And other than that, of course, it's, yeah, it's fine. We're, it's a public domain thing, all right? Like, I wear something, I'm a celebrity, you're a fashion blogger or a fashion critic. It's your job to, like, see what I'm wearing and give your opinion on it. I mean, I wore it because I liked it or I thought it was looking good on me and my team thought it was looking good on me, but you didn't like what it looked like. So that's fine. You're doing your job and I'm doing my job. It's not a big deal.
What do you think about actresses where, you know, we have this thing who, you know, wore it better or not? Two actresses wearing similar sort of outfits. You think it's fine or you think it's again...
It's all right. Like, I mean, one always tries to check with the designer that has anyone worn this before.
Yeah.
But sometimes you end up...
You don't.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't tell you or you don't realize, and it's not humanly possible to keep a track how many people have worn one outfit.
Yeah.
So sometimes it happens. It's not a big deal. I think that currently the kind of climate crisis we're facing and the state of the environment, I think that we must all repeat our clothes. We must repeat our clothes. We must recycle. We must upcycle. And it's okay if two people are wearing the same thing. Yeah, you'll just, it's good for the audience because you're getting to see different ways in which you're wearing
it.
You can see the variability of the outfit in different ways. It's great.
Okay. We're going to go into a rapid fire now. It's based on fashion, of course. Ready for it?
Yes, yes. Okay.
One actress.
I don't know if I'll be able to answer any of these questions.
One actress who is a slayer when it comes to red carpet appearances.
I mean, obviously Sonam Kapoor. She's the godmother of, she and Riya are the godmothers of Indian red carpet. So yeah.
Someone who needs to change her stylist?
No, I
Anyone's styling you feel needs a little bit of a revamp or?
No, do you think I am in a position to comment on anyone's styling? Like, no, most certainly not. But I think that I have a very good team of stylists, whatever you may say about that.
Okay. The most stylish looking Instagram account?
Priyanka's Instagram account is banging. I mean, she's having a blast and I love like looking at what she's up to.
Okay. Between Katrina Kaif and Deepika Padukone, sari looks better on?
They're both like, I think, the most gorgeous women that existed.
You have to pick up one.
No, I think they both look hot as F. I think, yeah, they're both gorgeous in their own ways. If I could get one of their, one, if I could
19, 20 probably, a 20 would go to.
You think I have,
of course, you
I
can
mean,
have a
I'm commenting on Katrina Kaif and Deepika Padukone. No,
but you can
I
have
love
a
them both. They're hot as fuck.
All right. Alia Bhatt or Shraddha Kapoor, boyfriend jeans with a tank top would look better on which actress? Between Alia and Shraddha.
Carry it. They both, again, both banging looking people. I have no opinion on other people. They're all better looking than me. They all have better looking bodies than me. And they all look amazing in clothes. But I personally love boyfriend jeans and tank tops.
Tank tops.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a great fashion trend and I want it to stay forever and ever.
Okay. An actor who should be shirtless 24/7.
Shirtless?
Yes. Very hot pot.
Poor fellow. I guess Ranveer, because he'd like take it off happily.
Ranveer Singh.
Yeah.
Okay. If you were a stylist, just hypothetically, think that you're a stylist.
Yeah. If I was a stylist, there'd be about 100 careers just going up in flames. If I was a stylist, I'd be setting fire to people's careers. Yeah, go
for
it.
What would you do to the actors? I'm going to name them. Okay. Ranveer Singh.
I'd be like, aaj beige pehante hain beta, theek
hai? Aaj beige. Aaj kuch simple karte hain, aaj kuch subtle karte hain. Priyanka Chopra.
Happy birthday.
Aap jo hai.
Aap jo karna karo.
Sonam.
Sonam would throw me out. Sonam,
you are the topmost stylist in Sonam the world right now. Just imagine.
Sonam is, I can never replace Riya in Sonam's life. I don't think anyone can. And Sonam thinks that, I mean, Sonam sometimes messages me and she's like, explain this. Like, to what I'm wearing. Like, so I think Sonam would throw me out before ever hiring me. She knows my truth.
Salman Khan.
Yeah, I'm too scared of him to do anything. Salman sir is, he's so
you
hot.
Don't have to do bad things to him.
Salman sir is so...
Like, I would, any I'd put him in a, you would want him
yeah,
to
yeah, in just like a basic Pathani. He just looks so basic black-colored Pathani.
Okay. Shah Rukh Khan?
I'd die. I would swoon and die. I would never be able to style him because I'd be dead. I'd just be on the floor.
Okay. So now I'm going to show you four pictures of your own looks.
This is the worst fashion interview ever with a person who doesn't know anything about fashion.
You were supposed to tell me what differently, how differently you, would you style yourself? Take this, out one thing or add one thing to the
this. This one, my stylist Divya Saini made me wear. And then everyone made fun of me because they were like, she's looking from Hogwarts school. But it was cool. I liked this.
Something you would want to add into it or remove it or change something about the look.
What, you didn't like this?
No, I found it okay. Like, yeah, see, I this, would say it's bad. It, but this, maybe the...
This, no, so this one was basically for a seated interview. So my point was that the photos looked good when I was sitting because you saw a lot more of the pants. And the cape fell like this. Okay. So in it, the whole idea of it was to be like seated.
Okay.
So yeah, but I mean, I didn't. Well, you didn't like this also.
These are not what I didn't like. This
one
random.
Is Shreeja. I like this. It is alright.
Yeah, this one even this I like. Nice. But anything you want to add to it or you would
maybe
wear
I do
it differently.
My hair differently. Yeah, I didn't like my hair in that. This.
Yeah, could have. I think probably open.
I'd like. I actually like tying my hair back. I'm a big. I'm just like pull it back and put it in a bun. And they're like, you cannot always be in a bun.
Okay, this one.
Yeah. Okay, this one. I'm sorry, but the background. The only thing I change in this outfit is I would change the background. Okay. If this had been a plain background, the sari would look much
the
nicer.
The sari is pretty, yes.
The sari is, I mean, it's a raw mango, gorgeous sari. I love the contrast, actually. And maybe I changed my lip color. Maybe I changed my lip color. Okay. But I should have hired a photographer and done a rollout wala photo shoot on this.
This one. This I quite liked.
Yeah, you liked it. I didn't like my hair in this. I would change my hair. Yeah, I like the outfit. I didn't like my hair and I don't like the shoes, yeah. I don't like my shoes in this. I don't like my hair and shoes now when I look back. But this is an old one, no?
This is quite old.
2017 or 18.
2017.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So thanks
but where
for
are the
your
good ones.
Are there were good ones also in that. I told you which ones I like. I like the green one, I like the last one.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for being on Spot Boy.
Thank you.
That was Swara Bhaskar for you talking all about her fashion and style. Thank you.